We are ready to go to an orphan meeting to Nambiti school. We mainly use motorbike as it is a very practical vehicle to travel here. The meeting program contains Bible teaching, singing and so on. Please join us.
There are two men who are spying. They are Daniel's fellow workers. And they are jealous.
This time, the Bible teaching was from Book of Daniel. Furthermore, children wrote also letters to their godparents in Finland.
They are planning how they could do something bad for Daniel.
Often the motorcycling journey itself is adventure, as it was today.
Aamulla 8:00 lähdimme.
We left home about 8 a.m. After driving less than 2 kilometers, there was too much water on the road. Water was over knee high and we couldn't get through. So we took another road, which was little bit better, but it made the journey much longer. And even there, I regularly got off from the bike and walked. Most of the bridges have seen their better days and are under the maintenance. Petrol finished also before we reached the filling station, so we pushed the bike about 2 kilometers. After the tank was filled, we managed to drive for a while, but then there came other problem for the bike. Then our other motorbike broke down. Finally, we reached the meeting place, got the meeting through, and at the moment we are in a motorbike garage in Chiringa village and it is 2 p.m. Today we are distributing maize. Nearly each month we are giving maize to our orphan families, disabled and elderly people who are in our program, and also for some people who are sick of HIV. Each family get from 25 kilo to 50 kilo maize per month according to the number of family members. Some years when harvest is bad, maize can be finished nearly all over the country at the end of the year. Then we need to skip over some months for contributing it, but we still try to find a way to help those in need. After 1 month, new harvest should be ready and hunger season of this year will be over.
This is the food item we have. On this side we have the maize. And the other side there, we have the rice. So what will be happening is this, that one family will be getting 10 kg of maize and 10 kg also of rice. So almost everybody will be going out with the 20 kg of food item. But this is just the beginning. We just need the prayer, how God could take us through this hunger season, and the hunger is just too much from Malawi and Mozambique. So we need God's intervention to assist us so that we can go through this situation. And it has been a big problem to get the food, the food items here. Needed to go far away, over 500 kilometers, looking for the maize, then looking for other food items. But with God's help, we managed to get all what we needed although others are still on the way.
Here with me is a guardian and grandmother for one of our orphan girls, Lucy Lakatika. Grandmother tells that she is looking after altogether three grandchildren. She also said that she came here today to get maize, and this monthly support helps her lots.
And how did you come here? Did you walk or by bicycle?
Walking.
She will carry herself.
And how long? It's maybe 10 kilometers from here to Matsenga. Is it longer?
I think we joke about no and the
si, no Kwanchenga. Kwa Mwarula.
Mwarula.
Group Mwarula.
Okay. Mm-hmm. From Mwarula, but it's far away from here.
And you are carrying the maize on your head?
Demunya mulajimanga pamutu vanu.
What time you left from home this morning? Do you know?
Mwanyamuka ntayo yanji mama wa mukumbukira.
Eta nyamuka mama wa.
Past jana.
Past 5, yes, past 4.
Mamawa.
Mm. She comes from Mwarula village, which is about 8 kilometer distance from here. She was walking all the journey, and when she is walking back, she will carry the maize sack upon her head. She left from home this morning 4 a.m.
And did you come today to collect maize? Mm-hmm. And are you living where? What village you are? In which village you are living?
Makaa muziwanji.
Here with me is our orphan Asileni Temwe and her brother Mundi. Their cousin John is living at our orphanage. Asileni and Mundi are living with grandmother. Altogether, there are three children with grandmother. And we were willing to take all those three to orphanage, but grandmother didn't allow it. She wanted to have also some children. HIV support group meeting is just finishing, and members are coming out from the church by dancing and singing. We have here lots of smoke, many ladies and also some men. Let me ask what is happening here.
What you are doing here?
Maya Bamugudan.
Dima Pikantio, Data Purapo, that they can tell.
First, they are cooking relish and they have finished now. They are planning to cook sima.
We have once a month HIV support group meeting here in Kambalame village. Both spiritual and physical food are available at this meeting. We have today monthly meeting for our HIV small groups. We just counted today how many members we have all together in those small groups.
All together in our HIV groups.
662.
662 members, it is lots. And about 200 of them gathers together to our monthly meeting.
We have,
and here is one of them, one of those members, Julita.
Julitalta muutaman vähän, että mitä täällä oikein tapahtuu. Julita, can you tell what is happening here? Once of month we are meeting. What we are doing here?
Ine jimendi sangala sabano patika kunguma na sonkano mene oma ni sangala nuotiti mamba mawa
mbaibu.
Julita said that she is very happy that each time here we are encouraging each others and we are hearing the word of God. People need encouragement because everybody is HIV positive. She told also that among this group there are several people who used to walk in wrong road, but after hearing here word of God, they have changed their way and they have changed their mind.
Ja käyttäytymisensä. I want to ask also, Julita, tell something about yourself.
Ine Julita Macheso, ni machokela mzungu wa Yohani. Ineyo 2004-5 na peze kandika kilomu kaicha.
She has been tested in 2004.
Hänet testattiin 2004.
And she found HIV positive.
Ja siitä asti sit häneltä löydettiin, että hän oli HIV-positiivinen.
And they sent her to Palombe hospital.
Ja hänet lähetettiin silloin Palomben sairaalaan.
She has been sick different illnesses like malaria and other things.
Hänellä oli usein malaria ja muita sairauksia.
And she always come to Mulungwali Nafe to collect transport to go to Palombe to take care of this.
Ja silloin hän tuli aina tänne meidän klinikalle hakemaan noi matkarahat, että hän pääsi hakemaan tuolta Palompen sairaalasta hänen lääkkeet.
And on that time she has been getting some extra food at Mulungwali Nafe like soya, a flour and sibusiso. And she is saying that nowadays her health is so strong that she can work.
Ja nyt tänään hänen terveys on hyvä, että hän pystyy jopa työskentelemään.
And for that she just praise the Lord.
Ja hän ylistää siitä Jumalaa.
I want to tell something about Julita. She is very active and she is taking care of other HIV people, especially children. When she finds a HIV-positive child in the village, she starts to take care of that one by looking that needed follow-ups are done and medicines are taken. She is great help for us. Today is a big day, a day of celebration. Our one-way churches, pastors, about 50 of them, get new bicycles. It is fulfillment of everyone's dream. Many of our churches are very far away from our place. It can take one day to cycle here, and without bike it takes at least double much of time. Today there is a great joy and with reason. Pastors are ever so happy of the new bikes. Some of them even skips over the lunch as they are so hurried to go home to show the new bikes. And normally nobody skips over the lunch. Some of our churches are far away in Mozambique. Our churches are poor and church members are poor. Pastors are coming to our place regularly in different matters. This place is like a kind of central place for everybody. Criterion of getting a position to be a pastor is very simple. One know Jesus, one can read, and one have a good reputation. Few times of the year we are organizing pastor training here in Kambalame village. So those bush pastors have had chance to learn more from Bible and then they can preach gospel in their own villages. And now with new bicycles they can bring gospel everywhere.
Let me take this opportunity to thank God and to thank One Way Mission for providing this bicycles to the pastors. And I also want to thank that this will reduce the pains, the challenges which our pastors from Mozambique and Malawi has been facing all these years. For example, we have pastors who are coming from Cholo. From Cholo to here is so far, it's over 300 kilometers, but they have been walking many days to come here, and they have been working to preach the gospel around in Cholo. But now this bicycles will enable them to go around preaching the gospel. Abusa poyamba tukuzueni zina ndi ndani kwa maso mkuchokera kuti
ine zina langa ndine best on sane chikopa ndikuchokera kwa Nkumba mpasa One Way Church.
His name is Silas Chikopa. He's coming from Nkumba, a one-way church in Palombe. Lerotu mwalandira njinga chisangalalo chanu ndichotani.
Lero ndi chisangalalo kwambiri.
I'm so happy today. First, I want to thank God. I was not thinking that God could provide us through one way church. Because when we were unable to go, we will be going every place because now we have the bicycle which will enable us to go in different places.
We
wanted to thank all the congregation and all the people from Finland. God should bless them so that they should also keep this help to others where there is the need like us.